I'm Tyler Batliner. Welcome to Hot Ones. This is
Mathew Kimaku. And me and Tyler are the Kings of West. Quorum King, Homecoming King, something light. anyways, we today are interviewing multiple people from multiple different events at West. And our first guests are Lauren Bennett and Brooke Tekka from Mr. Titan, because they're
welcome, guys.
Welcome to the show.
Hello.
This is the Asian Zing. It's a third level at Buffalo Wild Wings. So we'll see how spicy it is.
See how spicy it is. I've heard it's spicy. Okay.
Take a bite. Do I already eat it?
Yeah, just take a bite.
Okay.
Oh, that tastes good though.
The sound of us chewing. Oh my god. Oh.
They're not spicy.
So
it's a little in my throat.
It's getting on me. It's getting on me.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, what's our question?
Yeah, it's a little spicy.
This is our first question. What is Mr. Tiny? Why is it even important? Because people seem to not know.
So basically, it's a male pageant for all of the senior boys, at least in West, who wanted to showcase basically the weird parts of their personalities that they might not show at school all the time.
Mm-hmm.
Who do you guys think is going to win, like, in your opinion? Because, like, personally, I think Will's going to win. So,
Will or Jackson. Will or Jackson White.
Or Jackson White. Can we tell those you? Are my two picks.
I agree. Will does have a showcase in our dance that he always goes full out in, so I wouldn't be surprised.
Okay. Yeah.
And I feel like he'll do well on the interview questions, and that's a big...
You know,
big
I've heard, you know, Dusty, the substitute teacher, Dusty from this whole West, oh my gosh. People are in love with this dude. Dusty Stroop! he said, Dusty Stroop, he said he was on Mr. Time, right? And he said the hardest part was the question part. And that's why I think, like, because you can't be hesitant, you have to be confident.
Right.
And I think Will and Jackson have those aspects. But also, I know Austin Thomas has good speaking skills, too. So
the
that
best.
Be interesting. Yeah. The best.
He's the
He's
best.
An interviewer.
Yes.
And you know, I went to Mr. Bronker, by the way, with President Ali Steele. And it was actually really good. Like, it was amazing. They only had 9 guys, but they danced, they performed. And I mean, how has been making the dance? How's that been going on? Like, how'd you guys do it?
Well, we just kind of came up with it on our own. Like, we messed around for probably an hour in my basement and then taught it to them. I'm being real, that's how it was. And the past few practices, we've taught to them, and they've been picking it up pretty good, but it takes some work getting them to focus.
Yeah.
I think they're doing really well, and they're really showcasing their personality through it, so that's...
And it's super fun, it's super funny, there's a bunch of different songs. Can I say the theme?
The theme, yes.
The theme, it's a construction theme, is the name.
Construction?
So there's
construction?
So they'll be dressed as construction workers, and we'll basically just be doing a lot of butt shaking to the audience.
Yeah,
the song
that's
called
the twerking.
that's the goal.
Fan service.
When is it, and where, like, just buy tickets?
Mm-hmm.
Tickets, they're selling Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, the week before the show at lunch, so anyone can go up and get them.
And if you want to support one of the candidates, you can buy them from the actual boys and Mr. Titan.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And so I know there's also multiple, like, different awards. Like, there's obviously the big Mr. Titan award, but isn't there, like, an award for dancing and, like, what are the other types of awards you get?
There's another one for the one who sells the most tickets.
Okay.
There's probably some for the costumes and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's separate, like, sections of Mr. Titan, whatever. So
yeah, you'll get to see a bunch of different outfits and a bunch of different things like that.
Yeah.
Mm, and nice. Who has what's the best outfit? Have you guys seen the outfits yet?
Not yet, but we've heard of some of, like, the themes they're doing for, like, the swimsuit portion, things like that. So there's gonna be some good ones. Yeah.
Who has the weirdest talent? What's, like, the funniest one in your opinion? Who? What's, like?
We got a little preview of a lift up of what is it from High School Musical? The song.
Yeah.
I guess you can't say too much because we can't really.
Yeah. Yeah, but there's some pretty funny things that happen.
Okay.
Looking forward to it. The show is April 24th, also.
Mm-hmm.
24th.
Next Sunday.
You know, I was supposed to be on that, and then
you would have won automatically, so
you
missed
out.
You
had to give the rest of the candidates a chance.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. I have to be humble. <with that. laughs> Sorry, step back on that one. Well, I guess...
My cheeks are a little hot.
I don't know.
It's
it actually tastes
good. It's a good flavor,
good.
Right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But that's our third level. We still have 2 more levels to go, and the hottest one is going to be insane, actually.
Yeah, it's going to be bad.
It's going to be bad.
Very bad.
But anyways,
that wasn't us.
That is you guys.
Thank you guys.
This is Brick and Lauren. Everyone thank them.
Thank you guys.
Please, actually, it's going to be hype. I'm going to get so loud for it. The Mr. Bronco, the Mr. Bronco crowd was actually insane. Like, they were loud. And you said the Mr. Jag was really good, too, right?
Yeah, I thought theirs turned out pretty well.
Yeah, it's good to bring
back some fat heads of the contestants.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah. Let's do that. Okay.
So, thank you, guys.
Thank you, guys.
Yeah.
See you guys later.
Go ahead. Excellent show.
I've been really trying, baby.
I'm Tyler Batliner. This is Mathew Kimaku. Me and him are doing a challenge this round and the next round to see how long we can both last without drinking milk, which, like, I can't take spice.
Or eating ice cream either.
Yeah, eating ice cream too. I forgot about that.
Yeah, because that last one's hot. Yeah, it's gonna be bad. It's gonna be bad. All right, so, anyways, our next pair of groups is for Project Grad, and we have Natalie Still and Karen Mulder.
Welcome, guys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
What's up, y'all? Thanks for having us.
All right, so what flavor do we have?
Can we get plates?
they do need plates.
Hey, plates. Just throw them in. Thank you.
A habanero, the second level. Now, this has three flames on, it has three flames for Buffalo Wild Wings. So it's supposed to be hot, but.
What level is it?
On what level is it?
On the barbecue, on the.
On the, whatever, the level, the number scale or whatever thing. Exactly. I don't know. They didn't tell me.
But. I think it says it on the box.
Oh, it's a. It's seven.
Seven.
No, no, it's, no, we're order number seven.
Oh,
order number seven. Okay. So our second flavor is mango habanero. And it has like three flames on Buffalo Wild Wings scale. It's 7 out of 10 or 7 out of 9 on this scale that they have. And so it's supposed to be spicy, hopefully. I hope it hurts us. That's just me. Yeah. That's just me though. All right. Welcome.
Hey.
Welcome, ladies.
Thanks for having us.
No problem, Tyler.
Can we dig in?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah. Take a bite.
This is the time. I like the mango.
Basically, a party that happens right after graduation.
Right after graduation.
So we literally get on a bus from sporting, like from graduation, and we'll head straight to Power Play. And we have it rented out just for our school for the whole night.
Uh-huh. We're going to get back at West at 4 a.m.
4 a.m. Yeah, agreed. So, like, I know we did this, my brother himself, in 2019, he graduated. And so he went to this Project Grad, because everyone goes, by the way. Traditionally, like, the entire grade goes. Like, out of 500, it'd be like, I'm not gonna eat another one, bro. Okay. I'm gonna eat another one. This is getting hot.
You just have to enjoy the pain.
Well, my story. My brother went. And everyone goes, like, out of 500, like, 400 people go. And he made $300. Almost $300 there.
Yeah, everyone, we make money.
How much
money
are you guaranteed? What, is there,
you're
is
guaranteed there? You'll at least get your ticket back. I think it's $10 or $15 for a ticket. Mm-hmm. But you will absolutely get that back in some form, either if it's a gift card or... They have some of the different prizes that are really cool.
Oh, this is hot.
I know last year they handed out like a PS4.
Mm-hmm. There's prizes. Like other things. Money.
Yeah, but there's also just cash prizes and gift cards.
There's activities too. There's like axe throwing this year. I don't think they've had that before. Is your laser tag? Yeah, laser tag, bowling, go-karts.
Yeah, Power Play has a couple of mini roller coasters inside.
There are rides.
So it's really fun.
A hypnotist?
Oh yeah, there is a higher hypnotist.
Yeah, what? I'm gonna challenge him. I think this is a fake, by the way. I thought you hypnotized me. Come on, this is high.
So
no, it's like free when you get there too. Like,
when can you buy tickets?
Yeah,
there's like several different days.
Okay,
I've been like maybe.
How much is a ticket? $15, you said.
I think it's starting to get.
Hey, you want to take your drink? Take it.
No, I'm not. I'm gonna keep on going.
Ticket price is $10.
Our challenge is still up.
$10.
Me and Tyler's challenge is still up. We're trying not to get any sip of milk or ice cream. Brian, how's Brian? This you maybe take another bite of another chicken. Oh, you can have another one if you want. It's bad. So now I know, like, what's the importance of this? Like, people say it's a good last hurrah because like, a lot of people don't see each other.
I mean, we've been raising money for it throughout the year. Like, there's Powder Puff.
Yeah.
Is Mr. Titan stuff?
Mr. Titan.
Mr. Titan. Yeah.
We've done other fundraisers.
I know
and stuff too.
They have a lot of on their Project Grad's website. I've seen they've had a lot of night at like Sopranos Pizza or whatever. Is that right? Sopranos Pizza.
Sopranos Pizza. Best gourmet variety.
The
open late. 5 days a week.
5 days.
We open. We're open late.
I can't even pay attention to what's going on. I'm just seeing lights.
This thing is hot. This is hot.
It's hot.
Seriously. It is like a last night for everybody to like get together and just have a good time before we all head our separate ways. You know?
You can buy tickets at the lunchroom or in the lunchroom, whatever. Right. There's like six different days. Or Miss Ireland's room. So might as well have Ronda.
Shout out Miss Ireland. Ronda. She's amazing. She's a mother.
We love you, Ireland.
Man, her Ivy history class is a menace. That's just me. That's just me, though. And everyone else who takes the class. So I know Project Grad, this is the first year it's back, right? Since 2019, is that true?
No, they had one last year.
Did they have one last year? Uh-huh. And how, do you guys even know like how that went at all? Or
it went super well. They actually,
a North person snuck in. Do not bring any like extra people.
Don't bring extra people.
Yeah.
Anyway.
It'd be fun to bring extra people.
And you have to like stay there when you're there.
And yeah, you have to stay, there will be no leaving once you...
No drugs.
Yeah. School event.
A school event.
It'll be fun. Don't be a menace.
My mom is going.
Your mom's going?
Guys,
Janice is going to be there.
Janice is going to be there. Janice still will be there. So now we all have to show up.
Might as well.
Might as well.
You have the rest of the summer to do whatever you want to do.
Okay, my lips burn, but at this point I can feel them, so I can keep going.
Yeah, it's like...
They're numb, but I like it.
Yeah. I'm having a good time. I'm enjoying it.
Want to do that one?
Did we have enough for everyone here to do, to take one little bite of the spiciest level, which quite literally looks like a demon when I look into it.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're in the end game. All right, ladies, thank you for joining us.
Thank you guys. I'll see you guys later.
Peace. Come with Pleasure God.
Drink your chocolate milk if you need. Tyler, drink your chocolate milk.
I did, bro.
So I can beat you. Oh, so I officially won the heat challenge.
Can we all cheers?
Yeah, come on. I'm on this too.
Yeah.
This tastes
good. I used to be lactose intolerant, but here I am.
So, our next guest
is Will Gregg from the Spikeball tournament.
Welcome to the show.
Welcome, buddy.
Technically, Bashir Khalil was supposed to be here too.
But we're on a budget. We couldn't pay for him. So.
We were going to get a CGI Bashir, but we realized that's above our budget. Right. So this is a low-budget film. Anyways.
It is low budget.
This is on the hottest wings. This is the hottest wings that Buffalo Wild Wings offers. It is called the Blazing Flaming like Carolina Reaper flavor. And, I mean, I just see hell when I look into it. Literally flames, actually.
Doesn't look good.
It doesn't even look like it's going to taste good. That one looks just dummy thick.
All right. On three, guys.
Are you serious? Are you, don't take a big bite.
Yeah, cheers, guys. Come on.
Don't take a big bite.
Three, two.
You take another bite? Wow. Okay, here we go.
Whole thing, Mathew.
Speed run.
Yeah.
Ow.
Not even good, like it's just like immediately like
it's just spicy.
I say we go for two, guys.
No, you're gonna get hit with it.
I know.
Gonna be hit with the train. Oh my gosh.
Go to Mathew.
Okay, fine. I haven't had any milk though yet.
Oh yeah, it's spicy.
We got ice cream, by the way. Off camera, we got some ice cream. We didn't get real bowls, we had to get other ones because low budget film. Will Tyler also got some. Will did not. Will sucks.
Oh. All right, what's our first question? Tell us about the Spikeball tournament. Today, please.
Alright, so basically
get him ice cream somewhere.
We're running a Spikeball tournament. It's... Oh my god.
You took a big one. Oh my gosh.
We're gonna run a Spikeball tournament. It's April 26th. It's on a Saturday, from 12 p.m. to about probably 3 p.m. with the amount of teams we have gathered right now.
How many?
Right now we have
15,
about
right?
14 or 15 teams. We need 16 teams for the Spikeball tournament to happen. My spit hurts.
So we're having a ice cream?
I need some more ice cream. Bring a new bowl.
Come on, play go.
So basically, this is going to be a fun day. We're going to have a whole day, rinse it out up at Lisa and Westfield's.
Here's the car.
No. My hands are all flaming hot.
It's hot, guys.
It's hot.
Moral of the story, it's hot. And of course, I let this dummy peer pressure me into taking two. I graduated dare. I'm not supposed to be susceptible to peer pressure. Just saying.
Laughing hurts.
Mm. Spikeball tournament is it's about raising money for diversity for change, right? And so, do you have any real good diversity of changes for?
They were so bad, bro.
Wait, you have to answer the questions. What are the questions?
Right.
Diversity for change. What exactly is that organization? I'm built different. That's what I thought. Come on, somebody. Let's go. Anyways, this is a fundraiser. It's not just random. So what's Diversity for Change exactly?
So Diversity for Change is an outside organization, separate entity from West. We just work by setting up events, setting up fundraisers in the KC area to basically promote our motto of like spreading diversity and like collective groups. And not this, like we don't promote pain like Mathew Kimaku does. We promote happiness for Diversity for Change.
What events have you guys done so far?
So at the beginning of the year, we did like the selling of like these gold necklaces, which was like a smaller event. It was with the like blinged up theme for a Friday night last
year. It was for Student Senate, and it was called Tackle Hunger. We were actually trying to restock a lot of the food pantries around Lee Summit, our school district's food pantry, and also the community one. And we were very successful, actually. So we raised almost $200 for Diversity for Change, and that was donated. It was really good.
Diversity for Change partnered with Tackle Hunger and Student Senate to sell like gold necklaces, and people really did it. It was awesome. And then we did another soccer tournament, a 3-on-3 tournament. It's actually getting better now, but my lips are numb.
It's because the quality of the ice cream is nice.
Also, my nose like is running now.
I hope you have that camera on your face. Like, you guys got some stuff on there. You have to send it to us. Mm-hmm. So it's good stuff. But so I know who exactly is like the head of it. Isn't it Bashir and a couple of his friends?
So it's this kid named Max. He actually lives in New Jersey now, but he put.
It's getting worse.
Oh, what's good?
And so, yeah, this guy named Max started, and me and Bashir are continuing it for now because he moved. So, yeah, it's going to be awesome. It's on Saturday, April 26th, from 12 p.m. to about 3 p.m. Show out with your friends. You need to sign up using the Google form. I've posted it several times on my story. You can also locate it. If, I don't know, just text
me.
Dying.
I can just text me. He's dying. He's, I don't know, I can't think straight.
I can send you the link if you text me. It's going to be $5 per player, $10 per team. Team of two. If you don't know how to play Spikeball, look up the rules, get educated.
It's easy.
And we'll go from there. We'll have a good time on a Saturday.
Of the teams that are signed up, like, which team do you think is the best? I personally think...
I think Jackson Elliott's team's the best. It's Jackson Elliott and Jimmy Jansen. They're going to win it.
No, I think it's Jared Marlin and Brendan Garvey, all right? That one tastes good. No, those two, like, they just have, like, good chemistry, and they're good teamwork. So I think that's who's the best. But you also have a team. Who do you think is going to win?
Well, if I'm being impartial... It would be my team, but I'll be impartial and say that it's probably going to have to be Matthew's team. Because this guy, he goes crazy.
He sucks at Spikeball.
So good. Okay, I don't suck at Spikeball. Okay, first off, I can't slam. I can set up well. I got set well. My partner's really good at slamming. Kenzie Kaneka, she's insane.
She played volleyball.
Is she?
No.
That's yummy.
That's more glasses.
That's hot.
Are
they fogging up?
Look at you.
What?
What's your favorite color? I'm just curious.
Probably like red right now because that's what I'm seeing.
Just got in my throat.
There's a lot of red. There's a lot of red in my past and my future.
Yeah.
Is that blue?
And
so you were our last interviewee. And it's kind of that Bashir Kugel couldn't make it, but you know, we have him here at heart.
My napkin's supposed to be like a reviver, but it has like the sauce on it, so it's really just making it worse, but that's okay.
I think we're done, guys.
I think that was a wrap. That was good.
Yeah, that was good.
I genuinely had a good time.
Thank you for
coming. Thank you so much
for
coming, man.
Yeah.
Hey, man.
Okay.
Yeah. Hey, it was such a pleasure seeing you today.
Just get it.
I just don't. Yeah. I'll miss you. This dude's stupid, man.
Thank you, Will.
What? That's not my spoon. All right, thank you.
All right. Last thing, hot take. What is it called? Hot ones.
Hot ones. Hot take.
My mouth's on fire. I'm not going to throw up, but we're good.
Oh, I'm so good at those replays.